Welcome to Your Brain on Porn. This is a series for those who are hooked on porn. Only you can decide if you are. So, my wife and I have a website on relationships. It has nothing to do with porn, or at least it didn't. However, several articles were there on neuroscience of sex, orgasm and love, and evolution in sexuality and even addiction. So about 5 years ago, porn users began showing up. I guess they found us through Google and they began telling their stories and blogging and sharing, and more showed up and more showed up. We learned a lot. Here's a little bit of what we learned. Number one, internet porn is not Playboy, but I bet you already knew this. You know the centerfold of the magazine gets old pretty quick. Internet porn is really far more stimulating than just images. It's really due to the endless novelty and the ability to click from one image to another. Another reason internet porn is so stimulating is that it can escalate rather quickly to more kinky or more shocking material. Number two, addictive personality is not a prerequisite for getting hooked on internet porn. Now, the standard model is that you have to have a predisposition. You have to be genetically inclined to get addicted. Well, this is definitely true. But what we found out is that many of the guys who were showing up on the site had never had any other addiction. They were just regular guys who started watching and got hooked. And what's interesting is once they got off a porn session, they returned to their, quote, normal selves. Number three, understanding how heavy porn use affects the brain is very helpful to users. When you understand how the brain works, it really allows you to steer your ship a lot better when you're trying to get off porn. Here are the basics. Porn overstimulated your brain, and your brain changed. You see, being hooked on porn is due to the same brain changes that occur with all addictions. These brain changes are behind your cravings. These brain changes keep you coming back to porn, even if you want to quit. The internet porn is what we call a super stimulus. What that means is that it's way beyond what we've ever encountered during our evolution. Here's the big picture. We're a hunter-gatherer brain, living in a modern world. Our environment has drastically changed. I suppose I don't need to tell you that, yet our brains have barely evolved in the last 100,000 years. This means we are not well suited to many aspects of modern life. From living in isolated boxes, to going to work, to working in desk jobs, to worrying about global warming or the economy. We're supposed to be sitting around the campfire, not sitting in front of a computer watching internet porn for hours a day. Here's another example of environment changing, and our brains not quite catching up. I haven't seen too many pictures of fat hunter-gatherers, have you? And yet, 70% of Americans are overweight. So what's going on? Our brains are programmed to love high-calorie foods. That's necessary for survival. In the old days, it was very rare to find high-calorie foods, maybe honey, sweet fruits, nuts. Today, we have refined carbohydrates and high-fat junk foods. All of these are highly stimulating, so they cause supernormal stimulation way beyond anything we've ever encountered. Just like internet porn. Brain rule number one says, you must survive, which means get calories. For food, that means get it while the getting is good, because you don't know when something's going to rot, at least in the old days. So your primitive brain is urging you to binge at every opportunity, to get as much as you can. This leads to overconsumption. This rule also applies to sexual partners. Brain rule number two, making babies. Well, maybe that's rule number one. See, evolution's top priority is making more gene packets, more copies of you. Here's a question. In the lifetime of a hunter-gatherer, how many potential sexual partners would he or she meet? Not too many, I imagine. How about how many would he have sex with? I'm sure a whole lot less. A heavy porn user would view more hot babes or hot guys or hot whatever in one session than our ancestors would need in several lifetimes. So this can be considered another super stimulus. Our brains never evolved to handle heavy porn use like this, and unlike junk food, you can never get full.